Prince and Kiss. So they made their radio debut back here many moons ago. Since then, they've had two number one albums, won a Brit Award, been nominated for a Grammy. Bastille coming up after this.
The Six Nations across the BBC.
And that is a fantastic try.
A thrilling championship concludes this weekend.
Kicks for the post, and it goes over.
Let's settle it on the pitch.
That is top class.
The final day of the 2017 Six Nations, kicking off with Scotland versus Italy. This afternoon from 10 past 12, live on BBC One.
We were just talking about that as the trial played out. So this is your, that was your first ever session?
Yeah, it was here.
What are you saying, Dan? You were practising at your mum and dad's house?
Yeah, we were terrified.
That's so nice.
I get bad stage fright, but I was particularly awful back then. And I remember we were at my mum and dad's house beforehand, just going through it in my bedroom and... Yeah, it was terrible. But it turned out all right.
I think it's gone pretty well since then.
Your staff is back, so that's good.
Do you still get stage fright? I remember seeing, I saw you at Glastonbury this year and you were just about to go on stage, which always freaks me out because I always think the sort of acts, the lovely thing about Glastonbury is everyone just sort of just gets grouped together in a selection of fields in southwest England and you sort of just, you bump into the most random people. And I bumped into you and you were sort of, I think you were playing in like half an hour and I was just thinking, why are you here? I'd be backstage freaking out. But you said then you were kind of like, well, I'm going on, we're a bit nervous. And I thought, that's quite odd because I get, you know, with live telly and stuff, I understand nerves, but yeah. You must do it so much that...
I think that the great thing with us is because from when we saw you, we've kind of played in pubs and small venues and kind of worked our way up quite naturally, I think. So that's been quite good, and also doing it with friends in the same crew the whole time, it's made it easier, and I guess I've got used to it in a way. But you know, a show like Glastonbury playing on the other stage, or you know, a big headline show, I think it brings it all back.
Sure,
I guess in a good way. I think.
There's something about, though, I imagine the whites of the eyes gigs, the 200, 300 people that are just right at the front of the stage looking intently at you, you know, hardcore fans.
Yeah.
Is that more nervous than
I mean, you're well within bottle throwing range.
There's less of a barrier.
Yeah.
I love those shows though, because that's where we started out, and we did one last year under a different name in a tiny little venue, and it was brilliant. It was sweaty. You know, I like kind of spending as much of the gig not on stage as possible and kind of getting in the crowd. So that was, you know, it's kind of
did
great.
Did anyone turn up not knowing it was you?
I don't think by the end. It was, the guys who put the show on for us did a not so subtly worded description of the gig, basically just referencing volcanic disasters in ancient Italy and that sort of stuff. And people kind of had to figure it out.
A very important day in France. So who did you play under?
Well, our album is called Wild World. So we went under really subtly Chaos Planet. It wasn't. It didn't trick
you.
Anybody.
Saw like looking back, going, why did we do that? Why did we just, everyone
like
there
really
knew we're Bastille.
Idea.
We know we're Bastille.
It was probably the hottest gig any of us collectively and anyone we worked with was ever at. To the point where people were kind of leaving, coming back, and we had to stop the gig twice. People were fainting and being to open the doors.
The best gigs I've ever been to are the gigs where bands who have started small and gone big come back and play small. They're just that, because there's something about you guys as a band that feels like, wow, this is kind of back to the roots.
Yeah.
And something about the crowd that you witness at the moment is something special.
It was really fun. And I think for us as well, like you said, it was kind of a bit of a reset before our second album came out, to kind of go back to where we came from.
They're the ones you always remember, I think. So listen, let's have some music. What are you going to do for us first?
We're going to play our new single. It's called Glory, and this is the...
Now, we'd like to just say thank you to all the Bastille fans, because I think you put something on social media probably about 6 o'clock. Now, I don't know that the Bastille fans would be up normally at 6 o'clock, so I imagine they've been waiting for some time. So I'd like to apologise. I know we've got 20 minutes of the show left, but thank you for bearing with us. Over to you.
Deep in a corner of the night, we were lying in the middle of the road, counting the planes as they flew by, inconceivable imagining them go. And drunk we set the world to rights, as we fell and hit our heads upon the curb. You make me laugh until I die, can you think? think of any better way to choke stories told to me and stories told to you. And did you ever feel like they were ringing true? And all the words for glory were always sounded empty when we're looking up for heaven, looking up for heaven. And way down here upon the ground when we're lying in the dirt, there's no looking up. Gone to plan, but we made the best of what we had, you know. Passing the drink from hand to hand, we admit we really know nothing at all. Stories told to me, and stories told to you. And was it feeling real? And were they ringing true? And all that was for glory were always sounded empty when we're looking up for heaven, looking up for heaven. And way down here upon the ground when we're lying in the dirt, there's no looking up for heaven, looking up for heaven. I'll take my chances on the carpet with you. We watch the planes leave us behind on the carpet with you. We watch the planes leave us behind. And then you put your hand in mine and pull me back from things divine. Stop looking up for heaven, waiting to be buried. And all that was for glory, well, they always sounded empty when we're looking up for heaven, looking up for heaven. And way down here upon the ground when we're lying in the dirt, there's no looking up.
Love that. That's Glory, new song from Bastille from the album Wild World, which is out last September, which is still out now. That was lovely, guys. Hey,
thanks.
Carl, what's the deal? Does Dan come sometimes and just, because I noticed there, like, because you're on keys.
I can be when Dan is on the keys.
Right, so then does Dan just come and sort of, because you were both playing the keys there, does Dan just sort of, because officially you are the keys guy, so does Dan just sort of come and just go, I want to go on keys?
I mean, when,
let's play this together.
When Dan puts his mind to something, you can't stop him.
Right.
You know, so he's got to deal with it.
Is it weird the first time that happened? You were sort of just playing keys and he came up next to you.
It's quite
playing.
Nice. The proximity is quite nice.
Yeah.
You know, like during the song, I can touch him on the leg. No one notices.
Do you ever
use
your right hand and he uses his left hand and you play the same song?
It's like playing chopsticks when you're a kid.
but maybe we should do that. Yeah. Maybe the next one.
Yeah.
Come on.
Maybe the next one we'll do that.
That's good.
The piano's a big, cumbersome instrument. You should make the most of it, right? Fit as many people on as you possibly can.
Talking about your keyboard in a quite derogatory way, I hope you
don't. Yeah, sorry, mate.
Yeah, it's fine.
A big, cumbersome instrument. It's not fair, is it? It's a lovely, nimble instrument. The Nord Stage 2 EX. Other synthesizers are available at the same. Just back from St. Petersburg. What are the Russian fans like?
They were, I think, very appreciative that we were there. It was kind of amazing. We did a festival in the remotest part of Russia a few years ago. We've not really been and played shows in Moscow or St. Petersburg before, so everyone was very, very happy with there. Very generous with presents.
That's
and
nice.
A lot of pictures and art and things.
Did you get to spend time in the cities? Could you go and...
Yeah, we had 2 days in Moscow and 2 days in St.
Petersburg. Oh, wonderful.
Yeah, and you know, regardless of what, you know, anything, they are very beautiful places.
Yeah, absolutely. So very beautiful people, very beautiful places.
Yeah,
sure.
Wonderful people. Everyone was lovely, and it was, you know, in some ways feels like, you know, because the architecture feels like a completely different world, and we just loved it. We had such an interesting time there.
I was in Helsinki last year. You must have played in Helsinki.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I now, Helsinki, I'm told when I was there, was modelled, the same architect designed St. Petersburg, and then modelled some from St. Petersburg into Helsinki, I think.
Yeah, well, I mean, I guess St. Petersburg was, they say, is kind of much more European looking.
Right.
And we sort of did a kind of Baltic tour, and it was just that part of the world, sort of more Eastern Europe. A lot of the cities just have, you sort of feel like you're stepping into a different time, because there's so much sort of old architecture,
yeah.
The old towns in particular. It really felt like a time warp, and it was very cool.
Well, I guess it's different because you go to a sort of a big, big metropolitan city like London, and you see the glass next to the old Victoriana or the old Georgian buildings. We were there, it always feels, like you said, my wife's Norwegian, so I go to Norway a lot, and it feels far more preserved in that regard, yeah. You know? So second album, struck me as quite strange that you still decided to make it in a sort of windowless studio, where after the first album you must have had your choice of the Catskills or the Sierra Nevadas or somewhere nice and kind of rural, or you know, but you went Rocky Four, you went old school, you went back to the room.
I think you know, we've been so lucky to travel and spend a lot of time touring, you know, and I think that's one thing that we didn't really expect when we made the first record, was that it would take us away to these amazing places, but for so long. So I think we sort of love being in the UK, we love being home, we love being in London, and I think it felt really important to us, if we were going to have some time, to spend it here and not, you know, not go anywhere. And also I think, you know, Mark, the producer that we work with, it was, you know, we very much wanted to grow and develop as a band, but with him, rather than being like, right, let's go and find someone, you know, whatever.
Sure. It's funny, isn't it? It's the kind of, it's a weird one, that. I see with a lot of bands that you know, you do well, and first album does well, and then it's that kind of, there's a great line in The Road to Perdition where Paul Newman turns around to Tom Hanks and said, "This is a life we chose, Michael." And it's so true, because, you know, of course you want to go and see the world, and it's wonderful, but touring, there is a downside to touring, and it does take you away from your friends and family, and
yeah.
No one would ever change that, but at the same time, it must be lovely to come home.
Yeah, I mean, obviously, you know, we'd never remotely even, like, edge onto complaining about it, but it is interesting to just be away. And there's, you know, there's loads of jobs that take people away from home, and obviously this is not a job, it's ridiculous what we do, we're so lucky, but you know, just being away for long times, you know, people, things change when you're away, and you know, we like to be back as much as we possibly can. But it was nice to make the album there. It was, you know, it's like that little studio is, it might not have any ventilation, it might not have any natural light, but it's kind of, it's home for us, and it's, you know, it's there's
it's a
bus
space.
There's a bus that goes from my front door to outside the studio, so that's pretty handy.
Well, now I get one.
Yeah.
Okay, what are you going to do for us next?
We're going to do a cover.
Karaoke last night?
I was at karaoke. I was.
But you didn't play this in karaoke.
Well, I left early to be good and fresh for this morning. And as I was leaving, everybody was like, to send me off, did this song. And basically, I was there last night being like, this is, I've got a clip of it on my
and
phone.
You're sober as well, so it's quite odd.
Yeah, I was very sober, and also hearing it with the proper track behind it, and, you know, a 20 strong choir of mainly Irish people singing it very loudly, it made me nervous.
Very good.
So this is like the opposite version of
it. Let's not even announce it, let's just play it.
All right,
over to you, it's Bastille.
I could stay awake just to hear you breathing, watch you smile while you were sleeping. Well, you're far away from dreaming. I could spend my life in this sweet surrender and just stay lost here in this moment forever. Every moment spent with you is a moment I treasure. I don't wanna close my eyes, I don't wanna fall asleep, 'cause I'd miss you, babe.
Check you out with a Jive Bunny Mega Mix. Of R.E.M. and Aerosmith. Bastille, thank you so much. It was lovely. Wow, this is incredible. Thanks for making my cake deliveries late as I sit in my van listening and feeling weepy, says Ashley in Edinburgh. Oh, my days, Dermot.
Good weepy?
Yeah, I guess. Late cake weepy. They need to release that cover. It's amazing, says Alison in London. Guys, thank you so much. Charlie, you've got a lovely voice.
Thank you very
lovely.
Much.
Lovely. More respect for Charlie, I think.
Yes. Yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah. He's by far the best singer in the band.
Yeah, very good. Not just a sellsword. This guy knows his stuff. Terrific stuff, Charlie.
Thank you.
What's up next, chaps?
We, on Thursday, are heading to the US and North America for a couple of months to tour all over. So, which... quite excited about.
Yeah, I bet. Listen, best of luck with it.
Thanks so much for having us again.
Great to have you back. Cheers, really man. Appreciate you coming in today. Thank you.
Thank you.